मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड आई एम लिली मैडम. सो टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद द माइक्रोबायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट एंड इन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद द माइकोबैक्टीरियम लेप्रे. सो दैट इज कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सिंधु मैडम्स टॉपिक. ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट व्हाट यू मीन बाय माइकोबैक्टीरियम लेप्रे, सो फर्स्ट वील सी दैट एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डिसऑर्डर्स द माइकोबैक्टीरियम लेप्रे इज effective. Okay, so this mycobacterium leprae is causing a chronic infection disease that is called as a leprosy. Okay, and where, so it is a acid fast bacteria. Okay, so it is an acid fast bacteria. It is a rod shaped. I will show you the picture. And where, so this type of an infection is going to be affected mostly on the skin surface. Okay, and also your peripheral nervous system and the mucosa of the respiratory tract. Okay, and also in the later stages, and it may affect your central nervous system and different structures also. Okay, and you may see that, and these type of leprosy, comparing with the present situation, present these type of cases are eradicated, and comparing with the previously, and these leprosy is a terrifying, has like corona only. Okay, so how means, and who got a leprosy type of conditions, and they are rejected by the society. So that much of terrifying, dangerous disease condition it is. Okay, and next we'll see that, and what is mycobacterium leprae morphology. Okay, so what is a mycobacterium leprae morphology means, what it is structure. Okay, already in the introduction we have seen that it is a rod shaped. Okay, so it is acid fast bacilli and a pallor bundy like it looks like, and it's a globular masses. So globular masses means, so it looks like a cauliflower bunch. Yes, so it looks like that. Okay, and it's a curved rod shaped, and how much of size it is, 1 to 8 microns into 0.5 microns in size. Okay, and less acid fast than the tubercle bacillus. So here in this mycobacterium lepros also there are subtypes will be there, so in later we'll discuss that. And comparing with the southern mycobacterium, tubercle bacillus is more acid in nature. Okay, and live bacillus stay in uniform, appear solid like. Okay, so this bacteria is in the form of solid and also granular formation it looks like. Okay, and that lipid structure, okay, the bundle of lipid structure, it is called as what? Glia. Okay, so the name, the indicators of the granular bundle look like a glia. Okay, and the masses, okay, already I explained you that the globular masses. Okay, so that name is called as a globi. Okay, so means it looks like same the cauliflower buns like. Okay, and next one is jersey. Here you have structure, you have seen that it's a rod shaped, and so globi like, and it's a solid in form whenever you are seeing the structure of microscope. Okay, and next we'll see that, see globi shape means cauliflower bunch in shape. And next one, so cultivation. So here cultivation nothing else but, so where you can make the growth of mycobacterium leprae. So in here the cultivation is done in two ways. Okay, so in rats they are going to done, and armadillo. So mostly these type of armadillo, so you can see in African areas. Okay, so it's here, it's not available. So here in African areas, and these armadillo you can inoculate the leprous bacilli. Okay, so what they will do in this cultivation means, so they will culture the tissue. Okay, so the meaning of the culture means growth of the microorganisms. Okay, so they will collect a certain bacteria in a one area, and that area, so with some of the nutritional growth, and they are going to so make the growth of microorganisms. Okay, so that they are going to injected into, so either in the rats or either in a armadillo. So in the rats, so what is what, how they are going to do here means, see artificial media nothing else but the nutritious diet and tissue culture they are going to do. And in order to growth in the rats, so these bacteria will take 12 to 13 days. Okay, and in 20 degree centigrade they are going to so keep this type of and growth of leprae bacillus. Okay, so for this rat they are going to inject intradermally, and where, so 1 to 6 months these lesions is going to be developed one by one on the rat. See here the normal rat, and whereas an leprosy attacked rat. okay, and in the salmonellosis also the same way. So what they are going to do, so they are going to inject the Leprobacillus with the, and so in this cultivation only they are going to so train with some of the new antibodies, okay, and that antibodies they are going to injected on the particular person, and where some vaccines is going to be so kept by this bacillus, okay, and where the antigen and antibody is going to be act towards the effect of the mycobacterium leprae, so that they are going to see in the cultivation, okay. So the sample they are taking that for this means nasal scraping, okay, so in the nose, okay, or maybe the skin, so in the different parts they are going to inoculate intradermally or the or it may be the subcutaneously they are going to inject this kind of an leprae, okay. So that is regarding of cultivation, okay. So these elements Armandilus animal, they have shown the picture here, okay. So this is a structure of mycobacterium leprae, okay. So lipoprotein members, three layers will be there here, and metabolites, so these are the small, these are the metabolites, and these are the ribosomes, and these are the soluble proteins, not this dotted one, so other one, okay. The area of slight is green color is a soluble protein, and it's a DNA, and it is a soluble RNA, okay. So this is a RNA. So where this structure, it was differentiated by some of the characteristics under microscope, okay. So how they are going, this electron microscope only they have differentiated. For example, they had taken a cell and they had differentiated what is cytoplasm and what is a plasma membrane, cell wall and the capsule. So everything they had differentiated the shape, and as we have seen in the before structure, okay, and lipid bilayers, everything they have inoculated with the ultrastructural characteristics of the mycobacterium leprae, okay. So that is only this one, lipoprotein layer, metabolites, ribosomes. So this is the structure of the mycobacterium leprae and characteristics also, okay. And next one is the resistance, okay. So resistance means, so how much extent so these bacteria can be alive, okay. So you see that viable for 9 to 16 days in a warm humid environment, and in moist soil 46 days it will be there, and with direct sunlight 2 hours, and ultraviolet rays for 30 minutes, okay. So in these areas it is very resistant, okay. And already we have discussed that what do you mean by leprosy, okay. So it is a chronic granulomatous disease, means skin diseases, okay. So involving in the skin, peripheral nervous system and the nasal mucosas, or the nasal mucosas and also the respiratory system is affected. So incubator period means, so once the leprosy has been so enter into the human body, so within 3 to 15 years and these leprosy is going to be attacked and shows the signs and symptoms, okay. And where the infection is going to, the source of infection means where it is going to come from the nasal discharges and the skin lesions, means so the person who have the leprosy, so direct contact with the fluids of the skin, okay, and also the nasal discharges, and you are going to get the infection, okay. And entry means inhalation of the infection, arousal, smell, and through some skin contact, and also the prolonged close contact with the infective person, okay. And the principal target cell, squamous cell, resulting in a nerve damage. Already I have said that nerve damage, okay. So our skin is having a squamous cells, okay. Our skin cells are underneath, there are the squamous cells are there. See, once this leprosy is going to be affected with the squamous cells, automatically they are going to damage your nervous system, and you can see that it's going to be lead to the muscular paralysis, okay. And already I explained you the different types of leprosy, right, okay. So first one is a lepromatous leprosy, and second one is tuberculoid leprosy, and third one is dimorphic or borderline leprosy and the indeterminate leprosy. So first we'll be dealing with the what is this lepromatous leprosy, okay. So this lepromatal leprosy is a globy inside lepra cells, okay. So what is the shape, large member as a globy inside. So globy means already I have shown you, right, the cauliflower shape, okay. So mostly in the lepromatous leprosy you can see the large number of the globy inside lepra cells, okay. And it is also known as a what, multibacterial diseases, okay. And antibodies are produced, but they do not prevent the bacterial proliferation. Means antibodies will be there, but it is not that much effective towards this lepromatous leprosy, okay, and the characteristics you can see that erythema and bright brownish spots with the definitive borders. You can see, I'll show you the picture how it looks like, and you can see that plaques and nodules means so when you get the chicken pox, right, so how the plaques and nodules will be there, so in that way it is going to be situated, okay. And if the nodules are ulcerated, okay, so over your invaded, okay, when your nodules are the pimples are filled with pus, okay, and that is going to be so changes into mucosa of nose, mouth, upper respiratory tract, and through these ways, and you are going to infect the other person, and also it is going to be infect your mucous membranes, eyes, bones, joints, lymph nodes, and every your organ of the structure, it is going to be affected, okay. So it is a spreadable infection to your overall systemic function, okay. So that is the thing. And clinical feature already I explained you how it is, a lesions over your body and sensory nervous system will be damaging, and the facial disfigurement means it results in what, so leonine faces means, so your face overall it looks like a disfigurement, means all lesions is going to be occur over your body, and patients are allergic to lepromin, so means energetic, nothing else but, so they are absence in showing of interest, okay, or so they are showing a lazy, and also they are having some fatigueness in their process of this type of leprosy, okay. See here, so how it looks like, so it's a lesion, this is a pus formation it looks like, and early stage of the lesions, okay, the chicken pox at the starting stage, how it will occur, see here, yes, like pimple formation, it's going to be, this is a pus filled, okay, so this is a lepromatous leprosy, okay, these are the characteristics just show on the picture, okay, so on the face, okay, already I have shown you the, what is that, so leonine faces means overall face, okay, it looks like. And next we see the tuberculoid type, okay, so in the tuberculoid type, and we can see that it's a high degree of resistance means, so once it occur, and so it will not die that much earlier, okay, and you see the skin lesions of you and sharply, and demarcated means, demarcated nothing else but here and there it will be there, it will not be continuous, and here and there it is going to be leads, okay. And you see the neural involvement which leads to deformity in hands and feet, so mostly the nervous system is affected, and when it is affected to the nervous system, and especially the hands and the feet is going to be affected, okay. And the lesions also you can see, and this form of a tuberculoid lesion type is called as a Pauci bacillary diseases, okay. So what is it, it's a Pauci bacillary disease. And next one is a, so it looks like a like hairless plaques with well defined borders, reddish color borders I explained, right, so it looks like. And next one is a, see, this is a tubercular erythematous plaque you have explained, this one, and also the spots like over the hands you can see, so small spots like it is going to be seen in the arms. And next one is a tuberculoid leprae, so mostly like for example anaphylactic allergy will be the forming, right, so it's an the tubercular type, it looks like this. And next one, okay, dimorphous borderline type, okay, so borderline type means, so it depending, see, these type of lesions clinically resembles like a tuberculoid leprae only, okay, so the characteristic you can see it is a, so when you see the characteristics, so it looks like a tuberculoid leprosy only, so but so how it is going to be there means, so it is depending on the chemotherapy or alteration of hot host resistance, so easily you can so solve this type of an dimorphous borderline type, okay. See here, like for example I have shown you the lesion formation, right, so it's like this reddish color lesion appearance, erythema spots, okay. Next one is a indeterminate type, okay, so it is looks like a same like unstable tissue reaction like a lepromatous and the tubercle type, two characteristics you can see in this indeterminate type, so you can't able to differentiate whether it is a lepromatous leprosy or it may be a tubercle type, so two progress of spontaneously you can see this type of a lesions process, okay. So see here, so you may not differentiate the disorders, okay, so it will be presenting on the face but it's improper clear spots only you can see when it is near only. So here it's not visible that much clearly. Okay, and next one is according to the Ridley and Joplin classification. Okay, so one classification according to Mycobacterium leprae I have explained, and same thing the other author also explained, the Ridley and Joplin has been explained. Okay, so that is a same thing. So like tuberculoid, borderline tuberculin, and borderline, and also borderline lepromatous and the lepromatous. Okay, just headings is important, that's it. So pathogenicity they have explained here. So what is mean by, so the tuberculin, borderline and the lepromatous. So whenever the tuberculin has entered, okay, and high resistance is going to be shows the positive lepromin test. I will explain you what is lepromin test, and organism hard to find, and when it is positive and it is non-infectious, and localized lesions only you can see in this tubercle type. And whereas in borderline means intermittent resistance, some organisms you can see this one, and it is infectious, and you can see the scattered lesions, means everywhere it is spread over. And next one is a lepromatous, low resistance and a negative lepromatic test, and many organisms you can see infectious, and generalized lesions also you can see overall the classification. Okay, so that is the pathogenicity of organisms of Mycobacterium leprae. Okay, so already in a World Health Organization, World Health Organization only defined two types, that is, so paubicillary and multibacillary. Okay, so that organisms only, lepromatous, leprous and tubercle type only has been differentiated in these two forms. Okay, so paubicillary and multibacillary. Okay, so what is going to be there here means, so by the skin test, skin smear test is negative. Okay, the patient presents 5 or fewer skin lesions over the process, that is called as what, paubicillary. And whereas in multibacillary, when you have seen that the skin smear test is positive and the patient presents more than 5 lesions, means the generalized lesions like lepromatous, leprosy, it will be there. That is multibacillary. And whereas in paubicillary means only, so you can see the tuberculin type. Okay, localized lesions only you can see. Okay, and epidemiology, whenever you are seeing that, so already you know that the source of infection through nose and your respiratory system and your skin, right? And it's a type of an communicable diseases, and where you can see, and 2 to 5 years of communicable disease incubation period, and 6 to 8 million people are affected worldwide. Okay, and 60,000 new cases are estimated, and 60% of them are in India. So mostly this is epidemiology of previous years. Okay, and at present, and it was underdeveloped and eradicated leprosy. Okay, and immunity. So why immunity has included here means, so they are saying that whenever you have innate immunity, so innate immunity means what, by your birth itself you are going to acquire this one, right? Okay, so innate immunity exists against the leprous bacill in the humans. Okay, so what is going to be there here means, here the CMI is nothing else but, yes, so chronic Mycobacterium leprae. Okay, so innate immunity and acquired immunity. So here innate immunity means whatever we are going to have from our taking artificial vaccines, like, okay, so here what is going to be there here means, so these kind of innate immunities easily we can able to, so increase the or we can able to, so increase or develop the immunity levels in our body, and to eradicate these kind of an tuberculoid leprosy. Okay, and where you can see, so in the lepromatous leprosy, the patient have the large number of CD8 plus lymphocytes and CD4 plus cells in the tuberculoid type. Okay, so comparing with that, the lepromatous leprosy is very dangerous comparing with the tuberculoid type. Okay, so to explain that, they have explained what do you mean by immunity only. Okay, and what is a lepra reactions. Okay, so here two types of reactions you can see in this lepromatous. Okay, so the first one is a lepra 1 reversal reaction and a lepra 2 reactions. Okay, so in lepra type 1 three types they have explained you. So first one is a lepra type 1 reversal reaction. In type 1 reaction, so you will see that, so it is a fever, red swollen skin, and the tender peripheral nervous system is going to be there. Okay, so with this reaction, so you can give the treatment of corticosteroids and the non-steroidal anti-inflammatories you can give, so it is going to be subsides. Okay, and next one, in the type 2 lepra reactions. So you can see that nodosome leprosome. So this type is called as what? Erythema nodosum leprosum. This type 2 is also called as. So why? Because so you see that, and where it's the picture I shows like a nodules formation is going to be, means lump like formation is going to be there. That is very painful and ulcerated is going to be the first I have shown you the pus formation, right? So that picturization is called as this one. Okay, and also along with this, and it was accomplished with some fever and malaise, joint pain and nerve pain, IDCs and some of the organic, means so it is going to be affected overall your organic system. So everything, the body damage is going to be involved for the type 2 reaction. So in this form, see, inflammatory nodules or the lump, starting stage of lumps, this one. Okay, at the upper limb you can see. And next one is a what test you are going to make by this. Okay, the test you are going to perform on this is a, okay, so lepromatous lepromin test. Okay, so the test name is what? Lepromin test. So in this lepromin test, so it was given by Mitsuda. Okay, so it was given by whom? Mitsuda, in the year of 1919. So for delayed hypersensitivity only, so these lepromin test they have identified, means so to identify whether the patient is having a leprosy or not, so it is going to be identified, means hypersensitivity reaction is there or not, by this only they are going to identify. So in simple form I'll explain you what is this lepromin test. So first they will take one antigen from the body. Okay, so that antigen, so first they will be, so boil that antigen extract and in the isotonic saline. Okay, so now it is rich in a lepra bacillus, and also, and from armadillo, I have shown you the animal, right? Armadillo. So in that armadillo, so we have induced this type of antigen, and we have made this antigen into, make through the antibodies, right? So what is going to be there? The antigen are prepared from the armadillos. Okay, and these armadillos is going to be injected into 0.5 ml of lepron in individual causes of biphasis reaction. So what they are going to do, the antigen which was prepared by armadillo, 0.1 ml they will give, so adding with the lepromin antigen and early Fernandez reaction. So what reaction you can see here, means erythema and in duration of 10 to 30 minutes and diameter appears 24 to 48 hours and remaining for 3 to 2 days, like tuberculin reaction is going to be there, like for example redness, nodule and nerve tenderness and everything they have observed in the rat. Okay, so mostly in the rat only they have performed, and so in the human being, so now at present, so previously they used to perform, like for example skin test, like they are going to perform this one. Okay, same like skin test only, 0.1 ml, like subcutaneously only they are going to induce this one, and they are going to observe this type of reaction within 24 to 48 hours. Okay, so that's the thing. And next one, so late Mitsuda reaction, means late Mitsuda reaction means in the nodular formation reactions. Okay, so you may see that, and in some cases 3 to 5 weeks with diameter of 3 to 5 mm and 1 to 2 weeks it will take, and to show the skin reactions. Okay, that is nodules shown, the whatever nodules I have shown, right? So nodular and epithelioid cells and Jane cells, everything is going to be infected in this Mitsuda reactions. Okay, and what is the significance of a lepromin test? So significance means what is the use of this lepromin test. Okay, so you can detect that, and for only to diagnose the leprosy only it's not invented, and by some other test also we can able to diagnose. Okay, so with only with this lepromin test only we should not diagnose with the leprosy. Okay, and other we can see that, and this lepromin test is negative in the lepromatous leprosy, but whenever you are going in the tubercular leprosy it's a positive test. Okay, so it's not that much effective. Okay, and to assess the prognosis and response to the therapy, for example whether the drug effectiveness, whether it's a positive test indicates good response and as a negative test indicates the bad responses. Okay, so only effectiveness only given by this lepromin test. Okay, so which one, which drug is resistant, so by this lepromin test only we can identify. and the next one is the diagnosis of leprosy. So how we can go for the diagnosis means biopsy is one of the best way to diagnose the leprosy bacterium. Okay, so they are going to take the sample of the tissue and they are going to send routine examination specimens and collected like nasal mucosa, skin lesions and the ear lobes. Okay, so these type of samples and along with the tissue, biopsy tissue, they are going to collect and send for the test. Okay, and the specimens already explained you, nasal smear and skin smear and slight skin smear means in depth, and nerve biopsy they are going to check. So after specimen taking and they under microscope, they are going to demonstrate the acid fast bacill in the lesions. So what is going to be there here means Jean, okay, Nelson staining technique they are going to use. So in microbiology you are going to deal some procedures, and in that process you are going to deal with Jean Nelson staining technique. That is 5% of sulfuric acid used for discolorization. Okay, they are going to add this type of sulfur acid in order to demonstrate the lesions of bacilli. Okay, so this is a smear examination. So one plus, and so in the according to the microscope, they are going to visualize this type of size of the bacteria. So how much of growth it has. Okay, this smear examination is called as a bacillary index. Okay, so here they have given you 1 to 10 bacillus, 100 fields means. So in one bacterium area, 100 field of bacterium area, so how many bacillus structures are there? Okay, so like that they are going to differentiate. And next one, the bacteriological index. Okay, so the index score, so means example how they have done, total score of the smear, number of smear is 16/8 is minus 2, they are going to do. So the index is 2. So like that means 2 means what? So here 2 plus. Okay, so like that they are going to initiate the bacteriological index. Morphological index nothing else but they are going to differentiate rods. Okay, the shape of the bacteria like globy shape or rod shape, everything they are going to differentiate in this. And next one is the culture. So already I have shown you, so in the mouse food parts and the armadillos only they are going to do the culture. And serology. Okay, so serology nothing else but detection of antibodies against the Mycobacterium leprae. So already I have shown you the structure, like for example phenylon glycopid antigen and also the ribosomes DNA structure, everything I have explained you, the structure of roundish color Mycobacterium structure, right? So in that you are going to detect all the glycolipid antigen also in this serological test serum. Okay, and what is the treatment you are going to give for this leprae? Okay, for Pauci bacillary, what you have to give? Rifampicin and Dapsone. So the drug which was given in the leprosy, the whoever may be asked, that is a Dapsone only. Okay, and Rifampicin 600 mg once a month you have to give. Okay, Dapsone 100 mg per day for 6 months continuously you have to give. Okay, and multibacillary lesions means Rifampicin 600 mg once a month, Dapsone 600 mg per day, and Clofazimine 50 mg daily, and continue for 2 years. So these lesions, everything drugs you have to continue for 2 years you have to continue. So other drugs like ethonamide and prothonamide. Okay, so these two drugs they are going to give in the leprosy condition. So that mostly, so the leprosy day, okay, that is January 30, World Leprosy Disease Day is 30 January. Okay, so this is regarding of a Mycobacterium leprae. Okay, thank you.